In this video, we'll talk about skin cancer and answer the three most common questions people have about this topic. What is skin cancer? How can I recognize it? And what can I do to protect myself? I'm Dr. Lidia Schapira. I'm a medical oncologist and a professor of medicine at Stanford University. Let's start with that first question. What is skin cancer? The reality is that there are actually different types of skin cancer. The three most common are basal cell carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma, and melanoma. These three types of cancer are named after the specific kinds of cells in which they originate: basal cells, squamous cells, and melanocytes. Let's describe each of these in a bit more depth. Basal cells sit between the two outermost layers of the skin, the epidermis and dermis. They are by far the most common origin for skin cancers, with basal cell carcinomas accounting for about 80% of skin cancers. These cancers can be found anywhere on the body, but are most often seen on the head and neck. They are most often caused by sun exposure, or in a small number of cases by having received treatment with radiation as a child. This type of cancer grows slowly and rarely spreads to other parts of the body. Squamous cells sit on top of the epidermis. Around 20% of skin cancers originate from these cells, and they're called squamous cell carcinomas. Like basal cell carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma is mainly caused by sun exposure, meaning that it can be found on many regions of the body. The most common places to find this type of cancer are in the lips, places on the body where there is a scar, and on the skin surrounding the mouth, anus, and vagina. In terms of spread, squamous cell carcinomas spread to other parts of the body very rarely, less than 5% of the time. Finally, melanomas. Melanomas are a kind of cancer that starts in melanocytes, the pigment-producing cells of the skin, which give the skin its color, and like basal cells, live near the border of the epidermis and dermis. Melanoma is very rare, accounting for only about 1% of skin cancers, but is also the most serious form of skin cancer because of its ability to grow deep into the skin, invade blood vessels, and eventually spread to other parts of the body. It can develop anywhere on the body, even in areas that aren't usually exposed to the sun, like the genitals and the soles of the feet. So how can we recognize it? As I mentioned, the most worrisome type of skin cancer is melanoma. So let's focus our attention on what we need to know to recognize melanoma. Melanoma can appear as a new or unusual looking mole, but sometimes can also develop from a normal mole that someone might already have on their skin. Changes to the size, shape, color, or feel of a mole are often the first warning signs of melanoma. And you can use the simple rule of knowing your ABCDEs to remember these warning signs. A is for asymmetry. The shape of one half of the mole doesn't match the other. B for border. The border or outline of the mole is uneven with edges which can be ragged, notched, or blurred. C is for color. A variety of colors may be present, especially colors like brown, tan, and black. D is for diameter. The mole grows to a size larger than a quarter inch, or about the size of a pencil eraser. E is for evolution. The mole changes its size, shape, color, or appearance over time. In melanomas that develop in an existing mole, you might also feel an evolution in the texture of the mole, becoming hard and lumpy, and or increasingly itchy. Melanoma is the most serious form of skin cancer, but not the most common. So it's also worth looking out for basal cell and squamous cell carcinomas too. Both of these cancers usually appear as pink or red, scaly or crusted overgrowths, and both can also appear as an open sore that can last for weeks. Checking your skin for these signs of skin cancer will help you protect yourself and to know when to seek the help of an expert. Let me also remind you that skin cancer affects all different skin types and skin colors, and that these cancers can appear anywhere, including the scalp, or even in between the buttocks. With that said, it's also true that some people are at an increased risk of developing skin cancer. People with fairer complexions, for example, have an increased risk because of their tendency to burn rather than tan. People who have been previously treated with radiation therapy, likely to treat another cancer, have an increased risk of developing basal cell carcinoma in the radiation field, meaning in the area of the skin that received the treatment. People with some inherited genetic conditions also have an increased risk for skin cancer, so a family history of the disease is also a risk factor. Far and away, though, the biggest risk factor, and the one most within your control, is sun exposure and exposure to indoor tanning. Exposure to ultraviolet or UV radiation from the sun is a critical part of the development of skin cancer. And so the more UV radiation you get, the higher your chances of cancer. This is true with indoor tanning as well. There is no safe amount of indoor tanning, and any indoor tanning will increase your risk for skin cancer, including melanoma. Here are some friendly tips to reduce your cancer risk. Limit or avoid sun exposure between 10 in the morning and 4 in the afternoon. Wear protective clothing, including hats that can shield your face, neck, and ears. Plan ahead, and if you know you'll be in direct sunlight during the day, not just in summer months, but throughout the year, use sunscreen. We recommend a product with at least SPF 30. We also recommend reapplying frequently if you're in direct sunlight and sweating heavily or in the water. So, plan and prepare and check your skin regularly to look out for changes that may require a visit to your doctor.